a great rivalry, Texas-Arkansas. It's been especially far side of the end zone. This is one of the, what they call the white tops. And there you see it. There will be five of them. It's scheduled that President Nixon will be in the second helicopter. There is a presidential party which will include...
5 yards of the ball now.
Charlie Spire to the near side. The quarterback is Street. The wishbone tee in the backfield. A loose ball, and Arkansas has recovered. There is President Richard Nixon arriving on the scene, and he didn't have an opportunity to see Texas fumbling on the second play from scrimmage. Arkansas recovered, and now they have the ball from the 22 of Texas. Montgomery. Was he inbound? Yes, he was. Bill Burnett, as Mr. Nixon now, at his choosing, is going to sit in the stands with all the folks and watch this game.
Tough one to call. He called that he was inbound.
Second and goal, and Arkansas leads. Bill Burnett. Defense averaging 44 points a game. Third and four. Coy trying to get outside, and the 4 yards did it. Coy got 7 yards. Another first down for Texas.
There, Texas should be able to throw to him if and when they want to go to their passing attack.
Second and eight. Texas quarterback, first and ten. Pine Street on second and eight. Here's the first Texas pass. Cotton Spire and Arkansas.
Let's rejoin the action at the start of the second half. Arkansas is set to kick off, but first, let's hear from a special commentator giving his thoughts on the game so far.
Well, Mr. President, Bud and I are so pleased that you came up into our office to pay us a visit at halftime.
Well, Chris, it's a little warmer up here than it is down the stands. But I must say, I've never seen a football game where there's more excitement in the air than there is today. This whole state is just alive. I can feel it. We stopped at an airport about an hour away by a car, and everybody there, it's all they're talking about, this game.
And, of course, with their nickname, the Razorbacks, and the calling of the Hogs, it's the most unusual setting for this game.
I've never heard it yell like that before, and I'm sitting, incidentally, in a very interesting spot. I have four Texas congressmen sitting back of me and two senators from Arkansas. A congressman, and believe me, there's a lot of rivalry here in the stands.
You know, you talk about the pep rallies, Mr. President. In Austin, the night before the team flew here, at the stadium, their pep rally for the Longhorns drew 28,000 fans, most of them students, and that's most heartwarming.
Oh, that's lovely. Well, looking at this game, it is for the ranking of number one, incidentally. I say it is for that, having in mind the fact that Penn State's been giving me a lot of flack this week for coming down here.
You get any wires?
Yes, but Penn State is the team that will have the longest undefeated streak for the year. And you've covered them, and I know they're a great team. Maybe we ought to have a Super College Bowl after this, but what's the tremendous spirit that they've generated? It's good for people to be for somebody, to be for a team. And you can learn a lot from losing as well as winning. I've had a little experience in that.
Well, Mr. President, with the favored team, Texas, down 7-0 here at halftime. Now, that's true. The first half of your career, you were down, but boy, you came back a winner.
Well, I was down more than 7-0, I would say.
Well, I know
it was sort of a fourth quarter finish, you know, and a pass perhaps in the last 30 seconds by to win. But that's what counts.
Well, I'm one of many of the millions that are glad you won. Now, you've watched football for years, and I know you watch it from an analytical standpoint, whether it be on television or in person. Could you just predict maybe what might transpire in the second half?
Well, let me say first, the reason I watch it is that I sat on the bench when I was in college, and you learn a lot from the coach when you sit on the bench. As I look at this game in the first half, I think that Texas has enormous power that is really not unleashed yet, and that in the second half, they are likely to be much better offensively. However, they're not going to run over Arkansas. They can't do it by just going that 3 yards in a cloud of dust. the old Woody Hayes formula, not the Woody Hayes formula this year. I think they're going to have to throw more. They have an excellent passer. They're going to have to throw to open up the Arkansas defense. I think under those circumstances, they're likely to score once or twice. But also, I would suggest that Arkansas looks better offensively than I had realized. They could score in this second half. They have a fine passer. I don't think I've seen a cooler passer than Montgomery. He's really cool under very great pressure, and Texas has got a great pass rush. But Montgomery is cool. He gets out there and goes off. And I'd rather say that I expect both teams to score in the second half. The question is whether Texas's superior manpower, and I mean probably a stronger bench, may win in the last quarter. That's the way I see it.
Well, Mr. President, if Bud Wilkinson, our analyst, ever falters, we at ABC may call on you to do our commentary. Excellent.
I'm not thinking, Chris, of what I'm going to do when I finish my present job, but there's nothing I'd like better than to have Bud's job right with you.
Well,
I like football. This is the first game I've seen this year in college football, and I'm glad it's the greatest of the year.
Well, you paid all of us a great deal of honor by coming to this, the number one game of the year in the centennial year, and enjoy the second half.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Last year, gets a good kick, McClure. Bring it down at the nine. That is five. Gets away again. Arkansas, the Texas 37. And the fullback, Maxwell. And wishbone tee behind Jimmy Street. Bertelsen, way outside, Spire as a flanker. That's Coy. You've used well during the rest of the season. Flanker right, split end left. And it's cut and fire, losing the ball, it's still loose. And Arkansas comes up with its third fumble.
Spire breaking behind the linebacker, hooking, making a marvelous catch, and then losing the ball. It's kicked around by everyone, and Arkansas comes up with it.
At their own 47-yard line, first down. Defensive team at the 46 of Texas. Getting away. In the third quarter. Montgomery. Dykus.
Low motion. It's a beautiful play. Dykus to the right of your screen, starting downfield. Montgomery dropping back. This time, this is exclusive, of course, the split screen. Dykus taking a little inside break. Montgomery getting beautiful protection this time. And Dykus cuts to the inside. And Montgomery delivers the ball perfectly on target. Here's a great block. Beautiful block by Reese and Dykus, or Morrison rather, and Dykus walks into the end zone. Great execution, marvelous play.
And for All-American, Dykus is the near side, split end opposite. Street, Coy blocking.
This is Spire, watch Spire now. Breaking to the outside, Stewart going back, Street and Troop.
Spire low. He's going deep, it's floating out there. Dykus, the far side. On the flat, there is Dykus. To the near side. Second and nine. Third and seven from the Arkansas 41. There's Burnett. And Maxwell blocking Burnett. Burnett and Reese on third and six. There's Cliff Powell, number six from the 49 now. It's third down and five for Texas. It's a time-consuming drive. 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter. First and 10 from the Arkansas 44. See, will carry his live and in color press conference. Now it's second and 9 for Texas. Start of the fourth quarter. Jimmy Street in trouble. Gets away. There he goes. And Texas in 2. And Street. Two men to the far side. Dykus and Reese. Montgomery, the quarterback, from the 20. And Burnett. Morrison out on a pattern. And it's Dykus. Dykus, 6 catches, 117 yards and a touchdown. First down, Montgomery. Burnett. Maxwell blocking again. And here's that third down pass. Down the middle. I've won or shared the Southwest Conference crown 8 times. They're going after it again today. Third and 9, and at the same spot.
Breaking to the inside, then breaking downfield again, and then coming back across the field as Montgomery has all day to throw it. And watch that ball zip between the two defenders. Hear about that call.
First and goal from the 9. Montgomery. Side. Dykus opposite. And Texas gets an interception.
Let's watch the dual isolation because this is truly a key play. Dykus on the left. Montgomery rolling to the bottom of the screen. Dykus breaks to the outside. He appears to be open. The pass is just slightly underthrown, and there is the interception by Lester. It prevented the field goal, and Texas has the ball.
From the 20, first down. Getting to Ted Coy. Averaging 5 yards a carry coming into the game. And there he is. 100 rushing yards. A little more than 10 minutes. By the split end, Cotton Spire. As ago, his 5 of 9 passing. Now from his own 41. On the end around, this is Spire. He's at the 40, 45, midfield, into the Arkansas.
Here's Spire coming back to the split end, and there's a little toss. Great block there. Fine for
Brittleson to the far side.
Away from him, and Arkansas recovers.
Gordon McNulty picking up the fourth fumble against Texas from the 42, Arkansas's slot between the tackle and Reese at the split end. Burnett, third down and about 9. And Montgomery. And the Texas defense. It's Coy from the 36-5 for the Longhorns. About 5 minutes left in the game. For the Longhorns at their own 43.5. And going for broke to Randy Peschel. And Peschel catches the ball. From the 13 of Arkansas. That is Ted Coy. Goal. Touchdown, Longhorns, and they have the lead by 1. Or get within field goal range from the 20. Here's Bill Montgomery. The Dykus. Championship is at stake. Third and 5. And Dykus. At their own 42. Bruce Maxwell, the fullback, and a sure to the far side. Dykus to the near side. Second and 9. And Burnett. Arkansas now. Now with a 2nd and 3, a minute 22 to go. Here is Bill Montgomery. Trying to get Reese.
Texas.
Texas has come up with a big play. And, very fitting, Tom Campbell. He and his twin brother, Mike, are in the secondary.
Notably, as you can hear, and are greeting him singly as he makes his way toward Darryl Royal and congratulates him. Darryl. taking the sincere good wishes from the president, and they will be making their way up here to the platform for a more formal presentation. Every one of the boys anxious to shake the hand of the president, and he in turn very anxious to shake theirs. Now he's coming up. Mr. President,
how are you, sir?
Can we get Darryl up here? I know you have a presentation to make. James Street is here. Coy, Darryl, Coach. Here he comes. You chose yourself a football game to attend, didn't you?
One of the. There we go.
Well, one of the great games of all time, without question. And I was up in the booth, the ABC booth, at halftime, and it's there. I got to brag a little. They asked me what was going to happen the second half. Said both teams were going to score, but that I thought that what would really determine the second half would be whether Texas had the ability in the fourth quarter. Presenting this plaque, I want to say first that the AP and the UPI will name Texas number one, as we know, after this game. And this is a great honor in the 100th year of football. I also want to say that having seen this game, what convinced me that Texas deserves that is the fact that you won a tough one for a team to be behind 14-0 and then not to lose its cool and to go on to win. That proves you deserve to be number one, and that's what you are.
Mr. President, it's a great thrill. It's a great thrill for us to win the football game, but the big thrill, I know I speak for all of our squad, is for the President of the United States to take time to endorse college football and to honor you with your presence in our locker room. This is a big moment in all of our lives, and I'm speaking for the coaching staff and all the players.
I want all of you to know that we didn't make up the plaque in advance. It doesn't say what team, and I'm taking it back to Washington and put in Texas.
If I could add one thing, Darryl, while we're talking here. I do want to say that Penn State, of course, felt that I was a little premature in suggesting this. So we're going to present a plaque to Penn State as the team in the 100th year with the longest undefeated untied. Is that fair enough?
Fair enough.
And so a move unprecedented in college football as the President of the United States has appeared in the dressing room of the nation's number one team on this final day of this centennial year of college football, 1969.